summarize for the result of action research. The author has done an action research on it and some improvements of the system have been made each time as described in section .3. Summary of the result of that is shown in table 5. In the first trial, we have found that the experience of a managing student's project is effective for developing managers' competencies because the problems occurring in the projects are similar to those of actual large-scale projects. However, roles of the manager, whether mentor for students or manager for a project, is not clearly defined, which led managers confusing to do decision-making for their projects. Additionally, customer was not clearly defined for students. One of the reasons why to do was considered that a customer and a manager were the same person in several projects. Another one was that project evaluation policy was not clearly indicated to students. In the second trial, communication between a manager and students has been improved by actions A, project scope has shared between facilitators and managers with extending the manager meeting time twice B, clarifying the criterion for the evaluation of a project, that is, whether a product is accepted by real customers, not the same person as manager, or not. In this process, the project manager's role was clearly defined. Managers have no responsibility for education of students but must take a responsibility for a project's success. However, customer satisfaction of the products developed by projects was not good, because many common customer-developer communication errors were occurred. In the third trial, collaboration between a customer and a developing team has been encouraged, that led to a tiny successful system for the customer. The last serious problem is that large difference of the effects of education for students that depends on manager's quality. It is not fixed yet. Summary of the result of action research. Analysis for the effects by improvements of the environment. To analyze the effects of improvements discussed above, we have diagrammed the situations and results of projects that carried out the proposed PBL. The diagram model is shown in where vertical axis indicates a customer satisfaction of the project, and another axis to a project goal difficulty. Project goal difficulty / customer satisfaction diagram to analyze the project results. The evaluation for vertical axis is almost the same as the customer satisfaction that has been discussed before and shown in Table 2. The evaluations for horizontal axis have been done by the authors with taking the arguments from evaluators and customers. The evaluations are relative for among projects, and we has been appreciated the specification down project if that is with a contract of customers. The results of the entire project's evaluation plotted on the diagram in, and the transition of the range of the result is shown in. Plot of the entire project's result on the diagram. Transition of the range of the project's result by trial. We can discuss about the relevant of our action research and its results by using the first trial. The proposed model did not deliver the evaluation policies to students and managers. As a result, project members set their project goal and scope for themselves. That led to project's result to low customer satisfaction in spite of non-challenged goal had been set. The second trial, project scope has shared between facilitators, managers and students. Project members could not project scope for themselves anymore, which means to start negotiation between customers and developers in the proposed PBL. Although they could not meet the customer satisfactions, the challenging project goal had been created. The third trial, entire range of customer satisfaction has been improved because collaboration between a customer and a developing team has been encouraged by facilitators. We believe the challenging project goal and its successful experience bring up the good engineers, managers and customers.